And welcome back. Tom Hartmann here with you. And on the line with us is Jeff Charlotte. He's the author of numerous books, including The Family, The Secret Fundamentalism at the Heart of American Power, and C Street, The Fundamentalist Threat to American Democracy. He's also an associate professor of English at Dartmouth College. His website, jeffcharlotte.blogspot.com. You can tweet him at Jeff Charlotte, S-H-A-R-L-E-T. And Jeff, welcome back to the program.
Hi, Tom. Good to be with you.
It's been a while since we've talked. You're also a contributing editor to Harper's and Rolling Stone, I should add, the author of six books. Jeff, this piece in I believe it was the New York Times, What Was Maria Butina Doing at the National Prayer Breakfast, quoted you in yesterday's paper. And it was, it raised a whole bunch of questions for me and a whole bunch of flags that I wanted to get your thoughts on. If you could recap for people who, you know, may not have been with the program so long that they remember our previous conversations or may not be familiar with your work, who is the family, or what is the family? Where did it come from? What is its purpose? And then I'd like to get into why is this particular Russian agent of influence, shall we say, she hasn't been charged with espionage, trying to infiltrate it or play in that sandbox, Jeff?
The family is the oldest and arguably the most influential Christian conservative organization in Washington. It goes all the way back to 1935 when it was founded as an explicitly anti-democratic and especially anti-labor coalition. It was an anti-New Deal. That was what they understood their mission to be for the first 30 years or so. And more recent times, they're dedicated toward building a sort of an international network of elites. They believe that they serve God not by serving the poor, but by serving those whom they call the up and out, elites in power who are in a position to bring about this sort of kingdom of God they want. And their only public event, they're very secretive, they're kind of dedicated very explicitly. The longtime leader says the more invisible you can make your organization, the more influence it'll have. But they do one public event, and that's the National Prayer Breakfast held every year in Washington on the first Thursday in February, which the U.S. President always attends, as well as other heads of state and congressmen and Supreme Court justices. And it seems like a pretty blandly ecumenical event, but what they consider it as is a recruiting device with which they draw those with whom they want to have ongoing relationships into deeper conversation, which is exactly how Maria Butina used it. She didn't infiltrate the prayer breakfast. She used the prayer breakfast the way it was meant to be used.
Wow. So, tie this to the house on C Street and tell people about that. And is the principal agenda of the family still the destruction of the New Deal, ending Social Security, ending Medicare, ending minimum wage, ending labor protections, ending the right to unionize?
Yeah, the second part is a really great question because, of course, the New Deal is long gone in so many ways. But yes, I think it's fair to say that their vision of the kingdom of God is one of a kind of laissez-faire economics.
A libertarian kingdom.
It's sort of libertarian, except libertarian for the rich and not for the poor. They believe if you're rich, you're rich because God made you rich. God chose you to be rich.
Oh, so this is Calvinistic.
It's very Calvinistic, and that plays right into the house on C Street. They maintain a number of properties, a big mansion called the Cedars in Arlington, Virginia, where they host political dignitaries. They have similar real estate in Moscow, in fact, where they also host a national prayer breakfast. And on C Street, a house where they provide sort of subsidized housing for a group of congressmen who are in close covenant with them. And listeners may remember some years ago, back in 2009, a number of political figures, Mark Sanford, John Ensign, a congressman, all got caught up in sex scandals. And it was all through the C Street House. The family went to bat for them, helping to cover up the scandals because it believed these men were chosen by God. That's how they work. And you can see how appealing that is to someone who wants to do sort of backdoor work in American power. Here's an organization that specializes in working behind the scenes.
Remarkable. So what beyond subsidizing housing for Republican congressmen, which seems, you know, is like kind of the visible thing, and putting on this, you know, once a year, you know, let's all talk about how you know, nobly religious we are, prayer breakfast thing. Is the family involved in specific policy issues?
No. That's one of the things that distinguishes them. As an organization, and in fact in their documents they say, we as a group don't take action. Rather, action arises out of the groups that we organize. They organize the men and few women with whom they work into what they call prayer cells. And you'll have a sort of a weekly or bi-weekly meeting that's sort of a Bible study, but it's also a way for you to collaborate. So you might collaborate on a business deal, and that's happened a lot at the National Prayer Breakfast. All kinds of lobbying gets done there. You might work as Vice President Mike Pence did to help move some legislation beneficial to American missionaries in Sri Lanka and sort of trading access to American arms for that legislation. Or you might, like Maria Butina, seek to improve relations between Vladimir Putin and Donald Trump, not just through her attendance at the National Prayer Breakfast, but when we look at the affidavit, and she's quite clear about the ongoing relationship, and a relationship that I should say stretches backwards and is on both continents. It's not just that she came to the National Prayer Breakfast, it's that lead organizers of the family went to her in Moscow, meeting with her and her boss, her handler, Alexander Torshin, because they, frankly, saw this as a good way of making deals.
Mm-hmm. Well, I mean, I would think that most people, regardless of their party affiliation, would agree with Donald Trump when he says that our having a non-hostile relationship with Russia would be a good thing. But then, you know, the devil's always in the details with these kinds of things. How is, you know, I did not realize, or maybe I forgot, that the family has a branch in Moscow. How did that come about? And you know, are they trying to influence Russian foreign policy? I mean, you know, what?
Yes, absolutely, yeah. In 1992, Doug Burley, who is now the leader of the family, he's been the leader for just a year since the long time previous leader died after 40 years of sort of running the thing. Doug Burley is a sort of an old Russia hand. He's a long time evangelical leader. 1992, he founded the Moscow Prayer Breakfast, which is where which is allegedly where Maria Butina started making contact with actually NRA officials. And he also founded numerous other small organizations, prayer cells, one of which he brags is about 25 years ago he founded a group for young men, young promising men, and he says these guys are now some of Russia's leading business leaders. That's how they seek to do that influence, is to build these relationships from the ground up. And, you know, to return to a point, Tom, you said, you know, we'd all agree that a non-hostile relationship is better. Sure, but I guess I think the really deeply troubling thing about how the family works, and this is how they always work, is they seek those relationships not through any democratic means, but, as they put it in their own language, beyond the din of the vox populi. This is this pretentious little bit of Latin.
Vox populi is Latin for voice of the people.
Right. But they say beyond the voice of the people. That's where they think decisions should be made. And they really revere an idea of a strong man. Their understanding of Jesus is deeply unorthodox, even for the Christian right. They compare Jesus to, say, you want to understand Jesus? Look at other strong leaders in history. Hitler, Lenin, Mao. That's them speaking. I'm not saying they're secret Nazis, or certainly not secret communists. Wow. They admire strength. And that gives us a clue into their understanding of how you make peace between countries like United States and Russia. It's not through democratic open conversation. It's through serving the sort of the authoritarian impulses of men like Donald Trump and Vladimir Putin.
Does the family take public positions on things? You said that they don't do policy, they just bring people together. But, I mean, even something as bland, presumably, as, yes, it would be a great idea if the two, you know, largest nuclear powers of the world had a good relationship. Do they even go that far?
No, they take no public positions at all. And in fact, until 2010, in response to my reporting, they denied that they existed.
Really?
Despite the existence of 600 boxes of documents at the Billy Graham Center archives. You know, Billy Graham Center, this is no lefty center of lefty
right.
conspiracy mongering. You know, the documents were all there. The tax documents were all there. And if you ask them, they would say they didn't exist. In 2010, in response to my reporting on another one of their international involvements in the country of Uganda, where they had helped create something called the Kill the Gays Bill.
Yeah, you and I talked about that at the time.
Yeah, we talked about that at the time. They finally came forward and they said, yes, on national TV, they said, we've been very secretive. Charlotte's right about that. We've been maybe too secretive. We're going to start a website. We're going to go public. They started a website. I don't think it's been updated since then. It doesn't tell you anything. And that is the last of their public visibility. Even now, we have Doug Burley, who, you know, is either one of the unnamed organizers in the affidavit or certainly as the lead organizer of the National Prayer Breakfast knows more about it. It would seem like the right time for him to be speaking publicly. About what he knows.
You're talking about Maria Butina and the Russians.
Yeah, I'm sorry, the Maria Butina.
Yeah. Affidavit, yeah.
Exactly, that affidavit. We've got, they know something. Come forward. Show your commitment to transparent dialogue. If you believe in peace between these two nations, help it happen by putting it out in the open instead of this behind-the-scenes cloak-and-dagger kind of work.
Yeah. It's remarkable stuff. Jeff Charlotte, he's a journalist, contributing editor to Harper's and Rolling Stone, the author of 6 books, including The Family, The Secret Fundamentalism at the Heart of American Power, and C Street, The Fundamentalist Threat to American Democracy. He's also associate professor of English at Dartmouth College. JeffCharlotte.blogspot.com is his website. You can tweet him at Jeff Charlotte, S-H-A-R-L-E-T. Jeff, thanks so much for being with us today.
Thanks, Tom. Always good talking with you.
Great talking with you, too. We'll be right back.